هيا على الفلاح.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him upon all conditions. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah to forgive our shortcomings and to grant us goodness. Ameen. My beloved brothers and sisters, it is the duty of every single one of us to spread the goodness that we have. It is prohibited to enjoy goodness yourself. If you're a Muslim and Allah has blessed you with something, you have to think about how to share that. There's no other way. Otherwise, you're not a Muslim. One of the pillars of Islam is zakat. Zakat means you got money, you're not a Muslim unless you share that money. Do you understand what that means? So if Allah's given you £100, for example, and you have the nisab and a year passes, if you're not prepared to share some of it with those who don't have it, you're not a Muslim. So people don't look at it this way, and they don't realize that Allah wants from us to share the goodness that we have as part of your faith. I want to ask you a simple question. What is more important, your money or your faith? Your faith. So if it is so important to share money, do you not think it will be even more important to share your faith? So if you have goodness, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, "Balighu anni walau aya." You have to convey from me to others, even if you know a single verse. It's your duty. You cannot be considered a true Muslim if you yourself are enjoying the beauty of Islam and you're not prepared to share it with others in some way, shape or form. Not everyone is knowledgeable, but everyone knows a little. If I were to ask you, how many pillars are there of Islam? All of us will say, 5 pillars. You know that much, can't you share that? Subhanallah. If someone were to ask you about the Quran, what do you know of it? The little knowledge that you do have. So yes, it is a condition of conveying a message or teaching others that you know what you're talking about. But that doesn't mean you need to know everything. You need to share whatever you have. If you have, for example, a small piece of knowledge, a little detail of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wallahi, it's your duty to share it. So how do I share it? Number one, Allah will allow you to mix with and interact with certain people throughout your life. Every single person that you came across, Allah is going to ask you, what did you do with them, for them, to them, about them, and so on. Did you share any goodness? So one might think, well, how is it possible? I stop at a services on my way to Blackburn, for example, and there are 50 people there, 100, maybe more, and I come across them or they see me. How on earth am I supposed to spread goodness there? The answer is, at least by the way you carry yourself. Allahu Akbar. Your character, your conduct, it should show a slight smile on your face. Helpfulness, you're helpful. If you see an opportunity to assist anyone, you rush to it. That is your Islam. That is your Prophet. May Allah's peace and blessings be on him. He is the Nabi of Allah, the one we follow, the one whom we enter the fold of Islam by declaring that he is the messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So you carry yourself in a beautiful way, and the bare minimum is you don't cause harm to others. That's something. Imagine you walking into the same scenario, because it's not easy. People say, how can I give da'wah to all these people? Da'wah is not necessarily that you arrive at the highest of its levels, which is to engage someone verbally and to begin to teach them things. I may not know enough, or I might not have had the opportunity, or they might not even be interested. But when you see a person who hates and dislikes Islam, or dislikes what you look like because of preconceived, whatever it may be, within their minds and hearts, when you carry yourself in such a beautiful way, what does it do? The minimum is it makes them think. And that's it. It makes them think. And when they see the goodness, and when they continually see people of the same faith that they perhaps dislike with a passion, all being consistently beautiful in the way they carry themselves, the minimum is the enmity is reduced. And for you and I, that's a success, because guidance is actually in the hands of Allah. So if that enmity is reduced, wallahi, you've achieved. So now you carry yourself well, you are helpful, perhaps, you know, you don't jump into the queue and you don't make a nuisance and you don't make a fool of yourself and you don't start screaming and yelling at your own kids. They watch how you are with your family, they watch the respect that you offer your spouse, they watch so much more, they begin to want to be like you. Why? Because you have the deen of Allah. That's the reason. So when people look at a true follower of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they should begin to feel that they want to be like that person. They see the calmness in your attitude. They see the dedication in how you serve your family members. And you and I know it's very important to serve your family members in a correct fashion, because Allah chose them for you and Allah has kept it as a test for you. Your Jannah could be through serving your own parents. Imagine your elderly parents and you begin to push them on a wheelchair. May Allah grant them all good health. And those who've passed on, may Allah give them Jannah. But if you are to show that respect, they would probably say, I've got kids and look, this doesn't even happen. I wish I had kids like these. And then your beard is no longer scary to them. May Allah grant us ease. Your appearance is no longer intimidating. Because why? The truth has come out. What is it? Ah, calm guys, man. Sober people, loving. They smile, they speak with respect. Look at how they work. When you go out for a picnic, or when you're doing your school runs, when you're on the road, when you're at work, be honest and upright. It's the minimum you owe Allah and His Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why do we say His Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Because people read online and see things that are derogatory, wrong, incorrect about Allah's Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and about Islam as a religion and Muslims. Surely it's your duty and mine to do something about it. People think that it's going to be sophisticated. No, it's not. It's simpler than you can think. And trust me, many of us, we travel on a daily basis, different distances. Allah gives you opportunity upon opportunity. People are watching, people are looking, people are noticing, people are seeing when you misbehave. Subhanallah. On one hand. And the other hand, when you go out of your way to help in a situation that Allah has allowed to happen in front of you. That was from Allah. The same applies, you know, when Corona had struck initially, a lot of the Muslims did a lot of brilliant work. And so many people turned towards Islam or inclined towards it. And the minimum is they began to feel these people are part and parcel of our communities. And they're an asset to this nation or to the community. And this has happened in many countries in the world. So it's an opportunity. Congratulations to those who seized it. We do it for the sake of Allah. But at the same time, that reward is going to be earned. Similarly, it's necessary for us to expand our knowledge. You know, we have a center like this one here. Masjid with a composite center, mashallah. This is the favor of Allah. I believe this place was newly renovated, if I'm not mistaken. And subhanallah, it is a beacon of light. It's a house of Allah. It is a place where people are learning. Yes, it's our duty to be a part of it. You may not be living local in this area, but wherever you are, be a part of the society, a part of the community. At least go to the masjid, at least once in a while, because you might be working somewhere far, far out, especially in a country like this. But whenever you have an opportunity, go meet the people. Let them feel the bond of brotherhood, sisterhood, and inshallah, in that way, you would be able to help consolidate what Allah has blessed you with and I. Many of us are part of a community, we feel lonely. The reason is no one cares, no one bothers. No one's ever asked me, brother, I saw you cry the other day, you were not looking too happy. Oh, brother, I haven't seen you for the last 2 months, what happened, where were you? That's a little bit too late, because when you didn't see them for the week, you should, or a few days, you should already have asked. Don't wait for the 2 months. But anyway, it's at least 2 months is better than nothing. But imagine
you're going through struggles. People of your community who are members of the same ummah. And we said faith is much more important than anything else. And we share the same faith. And you know what? Nobody even bothered ask, are you okay? Nobody bothered. So it's important, my brothers and sisters, that we make sure we are different in that way. Ask, smile, are you okay, brother? Everything good, mashallah, or sister, whoever it may be. We have people who are struggling alone. That's not how the ummah should operate. Al-mu'minuna kal-jasad al-wahid. The believers, true believers are like one body. Are you really like one body? Are you really like one body? Do you feel, the hadith says, if one part of a certain organ is in pain. Thank you so much for listening to this short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope. And the same applies to all of us. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.